Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to discuss about the different AACR rules. We will be mainly talking the main rules which we use in order to prepare the catalog. So let's see how and what rules we follow in order to prepare catalog. We have already discussed in the previous video about Anglo-American cataloging catalog rule, that is the AACR, which was published first in 1967. The second edition came into existence in 1978. After that, the revised edition was published in 1988, then 2002, and so on. It includes the rule for general and media specific cataloging and applicable to catalog in any kind of format, which includes examples in print formatting, and the web version also links to Marc field definitions. The content of AACR-2 includes rule for general cataloging, manuscript, choice of access point, formation of headings, for personal, corporate, meeting and geographic names, uniform titles. So all these we are going to discuss in detail in this video. These are the main areas of main interest when we prepare one catalog. So we incorporate, we accommodate these information in one catalog: title and statement of responsibility area, the edition area, publication and distribution area, physical description area, series area, notes area, standard numbering or terms of availability area. This is the overview of card catalog which libraries prepare in order to maintain the card catalog. Most of the libraries now they use online catalog, but those who use card catalog, the size of the catalog is 5 × 3 inch, 5 inch width and 3 inch height, and we have certain rule where we accommodate information in more detail. You can see the elements of bibliographic description which we provide in one catalog, card catalog. At the top left corner we write the call number. After that there is a first indention, second indention and third indention, that is the hidden. And then we write the name of the author, that is the access point. Below that we write from the second indention, that is the title, colon, subtitles, followed by slash, the name of the author. If there is one author, two author, three author, accordingly we write separate, means followed by colon, the name of the collaborator, if any, then one dot, space, hyphen, space, edition, space, dot, hyphen, space, place of publication, colon, name of publisher, year of publication, which is separated by comma. Then we describe the physical information of the book, and that we start from the second indention, that is preliminary pages, followed by number of pages separated by comma, semicolon, size of the book, space, dot, hyphen, space, in circular brackets, series, followed by editor of series, which is separated by slash, comma, ISSN of series, semicolon, number of series. Then notes area, ISBN area, standard number, and then tracing. We provide tracing. And in India especially, from the fourth line in catalog, we provide the accession number at the left side. So these are the elements of bibliographic description which we provide in one card catalog. The chief source for different materials in order to prepare the catalog are type of material like book, pamphlets, printed text. So title page or title page substitute, means we refer as a chief source of information. If it is a serial, then title page or first issue or title page substitute. Electronic resources, resource itself, source with the most complete information. Sound recordings, item itself and permanent labels, video recordings, title frames, integral, container and labels, graphic materials, item itself and permanent labels, kits, unifying element, usually container, and especially prescribed source information for book. So the seven area which we discussed in the previous slide, the title and statement of responsibility area, we refer the title page. Addition we find on title page, other preliminary preliminaries, colophon, publication, distribution, etc. We get information on title page. Physical description, the whole publication we refer for getting the whole information about the physical description. Series, it is given on the series title page. Monograph title page, cover, rest of the publication, note, any source, standard number, any source. It is very important to understand here that when any element of description comes from outside the prescribed source, it is written in the square bracket, and it is compulsory to write that particular information in square bracket. We will discuss when we prepare the catalog in the next video. For example, I'll explain here. For example, suppose our book is Theory of Cataloging, written by Rakesh Gupta, and there is no by, means on the title page you don't find by Rakesh Gupta, and if you want to write in card catalog by, so it should be written in this square bracket. So that's why it is mentioned that if anything is coming from the outside of the prescribed source, we have to enclose in the square bracket. Now the important pages of book where we get information. The title page, it indicates the title of the book, author name, name, place of publisher, name of publisher. The back of title page we get copyright detail, ISBN number. Half title page indicates series, editor of series, series number. Preliminary pages, these pages are in the beginning of the book and written in Roman numerals like 1, 2, 3. Text pages, they are written in Indo-Arabic numerals like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on. The general information we need to understand when we prepare the catalog, these should be, one cataloger should keep in mind while preparing the catalog. Generally, the detail of first edition is not written in the catalog. When suppose this is the first, any book has the first edition, so we don't provide the information about the first edition. If there is any proper noun, then the entry starts with the capital alphabet, or capital alphabet is used at the start of every new area. But for example, if there is any country name, so we start with this is proper noun, or there is a proper noun, so we start with the capital letter in between the sentence. Unnecessary detail in publisher's name and author's name should be deleted. For example, in case of publisher, if it is Vikas and Company, so we have to write Vikas. In case of author, if there is a doctor, Mr., professor, Miss, Mrs., like that, if there is information, we should exclude this information, we should not provide in catalog. About the physical description, this is very important. If height or width is given in fraction, it will be written as next full number. For example, 22.4 centimeters, so it will be written as 23 centimeter. If the width of book is less than half of its height, or width is more than height of the book, both height and width will be written and separated by multiplication sign. Let's take one example. 22 into 10 centimeter, you can see here, if you divide 22, the half of 22 will be 11, and the height is 10 centimeter, so that 10 centimeter is less than half of the width, so both will be written. It will be written as 22 into 10 centimeter. In another example, 22 into 24, the height is more than width. So in that case, 24 is more than 22, so both will be written 22 into 24. On rarity degrees, title etc. of an individual are not used in the catalog. We use only surname and forename in the catalog. This is very important. If place of publisher is not given, so in square bracket we write small s dot small l dot and we close the square bracket. Sine loco. The meaning of SL is sine loco, means no place. The same way, if the name of publisher is not given, then we write in circular bracket, a square bracket, small s dot small n dot and we close the square bracket and we write as a s dot n sine nominee, means no publisher. If both name and place of publisher is not given, then we write in the square bracket s dot l dot colon s dot n dot and we close the bracket. If the year of publication is not given, the decade or century in square bracket with question mark is written with our own imagination. For example, let's take one example here. It is in square bracket 19 and question mark. It means the book might have been published in 20th century. If it is, means you are writing 196 a question mark, then means the book must have been published in 70s of 20th century. If two series are given, both series will be written one after another in separate circular bracket. If anything which is not given in the title, it is written in a square bracket. For example, and, by, anything you are writing from outside. There are three methods to know the real name of the author. Later edition of his or her work, in critical work or reference sources. If along with year, the copyright symbol is given, the year of reprint is written as the year of publication. This is most important. No added entries prepared by name of editor of series. If there is an editor of series, so we don't prepare the added entry for that. Bibliography info is mentioned in general note area. In my opinion, since we are preparing the catalog nowadays, online catalog, and our job is to provide the maximum information about one document to the user, so we should provide all those relevant information which we cannot accommodate anywhere in this general note area, so that the user, when they search the information for any document, they get full detail about that. If series number is given in Roman numerals, it is converted as Indo-Arabic numeral while making entry. Let us take the example of author case now. If there is a single author, then the main entry we prepare under the same author. But if there are more than one or two, let's take two author, three author case. Then the main entry is prepared in the first author name and added entries are prepared for both two author. If there is a case of more than three author and none of them is represented as principal author, then main entry will be prepared under the title. And the same is applicable in case of corporate body as author also. Principal author generally can be recognized by typographical differences in their name, such as name written in bold, typeface, italics, in capital letter. So you can identify easily that if there is a case of more than three author and any author is written in bold letter, italic letter or capital letter. So you can prepare the main entry in that author name. Added entry is prepared under the name of first author if there is a case of more than three author, and the name of the first author is written in natural sequence followed by three dot in square bracket et al. Square bracket close. This we accommodate in statement of responsibility area. If one of the author is given as principal author, main entry is prepared under the name of principal author with added entry under the name of the first author. There may be chance that the principal author is the fourth author in case of more than three author. So the main entry will be prepared under the principal author and the added entry will be prepared under the first author. If principal author is the first author, no added entry is prepared under the first author. If there is a pseudonym case, pseudonym means author may have another name other than real name. If both the real name and pseudonym are given, the main entry is prepared under the name of the author written first in sequence. Especially in library situation, we have to ensure that under which name the author is more identifiable and main entry is prepared under that name. I will mention one example here. Munshi Prem Chand was also known as Dhanpat Rai, but he is more famous with the name Munshi Prem Chand. Very rare people, they know that his name was Dhanpat Rai also. So in that case, we prepare the entry in the name of Munshi Prem Chand, and you can also accommodate the name of means Dhanpat Rai, so that in card catalog, means catalog, it will display that the author has another name also. If it is mentioned that author is more identifiable under the real name, then the main entry is prepared under the real name. If there is a multi-volume case, there may be different cases. There may be one title, same author. There may be one common title, same author, but separate title of each volume. There may be case, one common title, but each volume will have separate author and title. So in that case, if you have full detail, for example, I am having five multi-volume case, five volume, and I have purchased all five volumes. So I'll write full detail information in the catalog, content colon, and will describe. If out of five I have purchased, library has purchased only three out of five, so in that case we write partial contents followed by the detail of all the three copies. We'll discuss in the when we prepare the catalog. In two volume, if pages are not given in continuous number, the information is written as mentioned below, 2V dot in circular bracket, the preliminary pages, comma, number of pages, 310, semicolon, preliminary pages, comma, number of pages, bracket close. If the pages are in continuation, we write as 2V, then in bracket, preliminary pages, comma, number of pages, P dot, and we close the bracket. In case of 3 and pages are not in continuation number, we write 3V. If pages are given in continuation, we write 3V dot in bracket, preliminary pages, comma, and the number of pages followed by P dot and bracket close. Let's take the example of collection with collective title. In case of collection with collective title, is interred under the title and not under the name of the compiler or editor. In AACR-2 practice, main entry is never prepared under the name of the editor or compiler. even in the case when that work is not a collection with collective title and having the name of editor or compiler in author place, main entry is prepared under title. So, for example, phase script, it is used for personalities who are alive. Memorial volume, it is used for personalities who are not alive. And if there is a collection without collective title, if it is the case of collection without collective title, main entry is prepared under the author of the title, which comes first in the collection. So this is the difference between collective title, with collective title, without collective title. So I hope I have been able to make you understand the different rule for preparing the catalog, important rule for preparing the catalog. Thanks for watching this video. Subscribe to Librarian Guide on YouTube. You can also type the address in your browser, www.youtube.com/librarianguide. Thanks for watching again. Let's see more in next video.